good timing. Your sweetheart Maurice was just moaning at me. Says you got it all wrong. He's a patsy. He was set up. Wine, wine, wah, wah, wah. Hey, you mind if I drill a couple of rounds into his kneecaps?
Yeah, I mind.
You're so predictable. See if I do you a favor again.
Actually,
you need a favor.
I'm setting up an ambush. I need you to bring me some explosives. Can you do that?
I can do anything. Do I want to do it is the question. Yes. You know what? This is great. Yeah, let me round up the boys and I'll meet you there.
Hey, what is that?
Come run back and find out. I told you, he's bringing the boys.
Ah, Jesus.
I thought you meant the explosives.
Then I would have said I was bringing the girls. But I brought that too. No, I need some help. I was hoping you could involve these guys in a gangland shooting of some sort. I got a few loose ends I need to tie up and, you know, you do owe me those favors.
I don't owe you anything. Give me the explosive, something I can carry.
Fine. These two nutsacks are some unfinished business from a Gabonese job. You should have seen the way that they tried to take me out. I am driving this beast of a muscle car right out of the 70s. You know when an automobile accident was still called a fucking car crash?
Let's go.
Yeah, so these geniuses here think they're gonna ram me off the road with some plastic eco-friendly shit bug. It just makes this weird ping and bounces off into a parked van. Here, hold that.
Great.
Thanks. This is what I have for you. It's a sticky bomb. See? It sticks. Cool, huh? So these two idiots are sitting in their car moaning and whining. They're all fucked up. I don't know whether to laugh at them or scream at them. Finally, I just pulled out my 45 and slammed a couple of rounds into their fat faces. So that's what I have. You deal with all this for me?
No way.
We could just do that. Do that. Yeah, it's like a practice round. What do you think, fellas? Practice round?
Jordy, I don't need a practice round.
No, just let me get a little clearer.
Jordy! Fuck.
Thank you.
rep goes up, and then he's mine.
What's he holding?
Up. Not yet. Just trying to figure out where these guys meet so I can have some surprises waiting for them.
Ooh, booby traps, fun.
Regular parking spot. More tire tracks. And the cars come in from both ends. Still have time. They must do the deals right here.
Thank you. be ready. Bad bug will be here soon, guys.
Man, Boss wants his own cousin pop?
What the fuck you care?
If Bad Bug stepped up, Iraq wouldn't pop him.
Well, you tell Bad Bug. Maybe he'll step up on you.
Ben B's alive and no ass is there.
I'm just saying it's all. That fuck don't need to die.
friends can't come to the phone right now. They're dead.
The fuck? Hey, who's still standing? Anybody? Come on, man.
He's getting away. A report to Iraq. Bedbug's as good as dead. I just bought Bedbug the reputation he always wanted. Now, I need to scare him over to my side. A little blackmail threat should convince him to help me. I give, but I can also take away.
Yeah, I see.
Why'd you hang up on me?
And what the fuck? Man, who are you?
Just another player. I had a job for you. But it's not a job for Tyrone. It's a job for Bedbug. I'll be in touch.
Well, what is this? Come on, man! Somebody's after me. They're all dead. You gotta get me out of here.
You fucked in the head, man. That's for you.
No, no, wait. Come on, man.
What I'm trying to say, you're not listening.
Get in there. What about Iraq?
No, stop.
That ain't funny.
Don't worry about Iraq. Worry about me. No, it sounds like the club don't trust Iraq no more. Good. No.
I see. Yeah, but...
What you want?
You're gonna be my eyes and ears inside Rossi Fremont.
No, Wayman, Iraq will kill me!
Yeah, what will he do when I send him everything I've got? You wanna see more?
No! Just erase this shit, please!
Will you play along like a good little bug? And I will. I'll be in touch.
What is this shit? You're telling me... I said... Right. Yeah, right.
That's not right no more.
Good. Huh? No, that's ridiculous. That's bullshit. Okay, fine.
Tell me how to get close to Iraq.
You ain't getting close to Iraq, man. Forget it. He never comes out.
You want to rethink your answer?
Wait. The auction. He'll be at Quinn's auction.
What kind of auction?
Private. Not your normal kind of auction. Invite only.
So get me an invite.
Who do you think I am?
All right. I'll be in touch. Be ready.
How did it go? Did you find a way into Iraq's building?
Yeah, Bedbug's on board and waiting for my call. Let's talk about the access card Iraq was wearing. That's our only way into his room.
It's an RFID tag. We can clone it, but you need to get very close.
Bedbug says Iraq's attending an auction. That's my chance.
The auction, yes. Remember that briefcase Iraq had?
Hard to forget. Crushed the guy's skull with it.
Right. He said it had the guest list inside. You can't thank me now, because I've been checking that case. Now let me check.
That was quick thinking. Hey, if we get that briefcase, can you find me a name on the guest list? A name I can borrow.
Exactly my thoughts. I'm sending the briefcase location now.
It is cold as fuck out here.
Can you spare me enough for bus fare?
Hello? I take my business very seriously. Don't waste my time.
All right.
Drive it like a man.
WKZ-TV's recent opinion poll shows that people are rallying on the side of vigilante suspect Aiden Pierce. People are even offering to protect Pierce. However, Chicago PD warns that doing so could lead to criminal charges.
Explain to me how the fuck some guy is managing.
One more target. One more set of access data. However, you and I has ends. Uh-oh. You have company. Get out of there.
Call for now.
him next time.
Like your kind. The kind that doesn't ask too many questions and drives really crazy. You've earned our respect. We're bowing right now. We thank you for your efforts. You've earned our trust. Will you join us for our celebration?
Okay, she's ready when you are.
Get out!
Jesus!
Exclusive spot. Hey, bring a date.
Right. Really? This jacket ain't cutting it.
Have any change, please?
No. Go ahead. Whatever, man.
Yeah. Over 70% off. Everything must go. The economy's lost. Your game.
It's not supposed to be this cold today.
Hang on, son. I'll make you a believer yet. Okay, I know what you're thinking. I'm trying to sell you a gun, but it ain't that. Take one, you'll see.
What?
Right.
Yeah.
Can you spare anything?
I don't know. They escorted him out of the building. He wasn't even allowed to speak to anyone or get his stuff. But why? Don't play innocent with me.
I'll need to move carefully. If I can count on anything, Damien will be working at an angle. He's got another agenda. Okay, right now I need that briefcase.
Starting with the boss wanted me to explain just how important this is. You're not just carrying a
over
case of names
off.
And invites.
Everything must
you're
go. The economy's lost, your game.
Business.
Looking for donations.
Indiscretions, tendencies, everything Quinn needs to keep his guests loyal. Got it? Now pretend this thing is full of solid fucking gold bricks.
Help save our planet. Practical everyday tips. Please, help save the planet.
I do, it's moving.
Okay, I know what you're
wait,
thinking. I'm trying to sell
you. I can't believe it.
What?
Quinn's guys are pulling some old school gangster shit. A briefcase swap. Really?
Do those actually work?
Never seen one of these. Why are they doing this? Did they fool CTOS?
Anybody watching through a monitor would see every swap.
They're trying to confuse the detection software. Interesting. Got the case on a boat heading upriver. I got a bike here. I'm gonna follow.
Maybe I can see where they're going. Give me a sec.
What do you have nearby? My guess, this will be a short trip. There's another drop for another pickup.
Okay. Nope. Wait. There's an old marina bought by Lucky Quinn in 1967.
That's gotta be it.
Says it's been closed to the public since the 80s.
We'll be right back.
that?
Sending the guest list from the case. Whatever this auction is, the club's not taking chances. Security will be tight.
Okay, so we'll find you a suitable identity. Not a regular.
Someone from out of the country. A guy they won't recognize.
Okay. Okay. This one. Can you pull off a Mr. Pang?
I don't think so. Any Europeans?
Nicholas Crispin. 32 years old. Expat American. Haven't been back in 12 years.
That's the one.
Oh my god. They list his preferences. This man is sick. And filthy rich, too.
Will anyone miss him?
What do you mean, miss him?
Clara, if I'm stealing his identity, I can't have him around blowing my cover. I can't keep him alive.
Oh. No, I guess not.
My sister's missing, Clara. I'm gonna do whatever it takes to get her. Listen, if this is too much for you, you can walk away. I'll understand.
No, I'm fine. Nobody's going to miss this dog. This is a good match. He's supposed to pick up his car at the dealership.
All right. I'll meet him there. Jack's uncle. I want to make sure things are going okay there.
First, I want to know if things are okay with Nikki. We haven't heard from her.
She's still working things out. She just needs a little more time.
Well, Jackson misses her terribly. She should at least give him a call. I can tell he's restless. He's not happy here.
I understand. And I'll let her know. You have any problems with Jackson? Anything at all? If he wanders off or anything, you call me right away.
I will. You take care of that sister of yours.
Yeah. I am.
Your ride's ready. Gassed up, wheels balanced, fluids checked, the works. You're welcome.
I thought he'd fit in. He's smart.
Sure. Look, it's got nothing to do with how he looks, so whatever religion them people...
Chicago's citizens are cheering Pierce on. With so much citizen support, police are having a hard time getting any tips on his whereabouts.
See ya.
Dude, you are in my bubble. Whoa!
Save the planet.
Now. Need to find this guy.
Hey, dude, what's the best nation? It's a donation! That's right! You look like a generous person. The Lord thanks you kindly if you help us fill out.
Where the fuck do you think you're going?
Oh God, what are you doing here?
We're not through till I say we are.
You!
Enjoying the show?
Stop!
Renowned psychologist Dr. Phil Edelman. Doctor, the city has a vigilante in its midst, as you know. But you think this is a good thing?
Well, I hesitate to say good, but I think in a city with rising gang violence and a notorious history, citizens need to feel safe.
And he makes them feel safe?
He gives the illusion of safety. People shouldn't think he's a hero, of course.
What about his mental state? Is he just crazy?
I don't like the word crazy. He has a purpose. He's someone who has lost control or feels out of control. In his mind, he's regaining it. He was probably a victim of a crime, and this is his way of lashing out. But once he's achieved that sense...
Uh-huh.
can hide behind urban camouflage, but we know where they hide their servers. We need your skills on the ground. We'll put the access data you recovered to use, but contractors will be dispatched to stop our intrusion attack. You will stop the contractors. Are you with us?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, don't panic. There's gotta be a disarm sequence. Think, damn it. Think.
Everyone check in here. Explosives might be defective.
Stop waiting.
Sight of the suspect, attempting to reestablish.
identify the suspect.
That was most brave. And while Human Eye scrambles to explain their secrets, we leave our best secret behind. Asleep in their network, watching and waiting. But for now, we party. Dress accordingly.
I always do.
So, what?